My family, we come up Leon County, Centerville, Texas. You know, raise cotton and corn and peas and peanuts and things like that. So I got me a guitar of my own when I got to be 8 years old. I got me a cigar box. I cut me a hole in the round hole in the middle of it. Take me a little piece of plank, nail it onto that cigar box, and I got me some screen wire, and I got me a tune out of it. And from that, I kept my tune.
But my brother did this song, which he got from me, which I got from Lightnin, which was called Lightnin's Boogie. And it was a big famous Lightnin Hopkins song, you know, and it was something like this. Kind of stuff, you know, whenever you hear this. That was Lightnin Hopkins. I never heard anybody else do that. Like folk guys did it later, you know, but it was Lightnin Hopkins. I don't think there could be a B.B. King or a Buddy Guy or a Jimi Hendrix or a Stevie Ray Vaughan without Lightnin Hopkins.
Please give me tonight.
The first time I heard Lightnin Hopkins had to be the very early 50s. I was a disc jockey during that time in Memphis, Tennessee. And I got a record that someone sent me. And the title of the tune was Operator or 209, something like that, because his first lines was Operator, would you please give me 209, something like that. And I said, oh boy, I like this guy. I like this guy. I hate to think of not having a Lightnin Hopkins. The blues would never have been, I think, like what it turned out to be. Because he, like I said earlier, was a great player. He didn't put sugar on anything, he just played it. And to me, that's the kind of blues we need in a lot of cases. And he did that.
The telephone went walking straight back home.